Is it visible now? Now it's came back. Now it's visible now. Am I audible? Yes. Fine, fine. So here, in order to print in your using your write line, it can only accept these strings. So for that, we have a method called toString. So toString is a method which will convert anything into type string. Okay, like this. So is there any doubts in this? You may experience so many disturbances while I'm teaching because there is some power problem here and internet issue also. So most of the time I'm just trying to connect as early as possible. Okay, now let's run this. Okay, so it will be, so every output was printed. So if we check in the output console, so 2, 4, 6, 8, everything, because you have a difference of 2, because I am incrementing it as number plus 2. Okay, so any doubts here? What happens if we swap the assign and write line blocks? So first number 0 will be printed, then your number will be incremented. Very simple. If you want to swap it, let's swap. I've swapped here like this. Now save. Let me clear this output console. Let me close this, save and run. So 0 will be printed because at start you are printing 0. So if your assign is here, the first thing will be your 2. What we have to do when it goes to infinite loop? We need to stop it manually. We need to stop it manually. Okay. We can do this while you are executing. Just stop it manually. So why it is going to home screen and come back to a page? Home screen. I didn't get you, Jagan Reddy. After running, yes, it need to execute, right? While it is executing, automatically your UFS studio will be minimizing. It may expect some message box. For suppose if you are keeping a message box, what it will do, it will be need to minimize this UFS studio and it need to show something in your message box, right? So that is what actually happened. So without having any message box, directly your output console is having your write line statement, which is executing here, your write line activity. That's why it was minimizing every time this UI pass, and it was coming back. Every time it will happen like that. Because what you are doing is you are making some activity to be run in your sequence. So it doesn't know what was activity. When it was started, it will start from this while loop. Okay, it will start with this while loop. So what it will just read the sequence. Okay, it will just first compile. For after the compilation, while it will compile, it will minimize. If there is any errors, it will show you immediately. So if there were no compilation errors, it will start its execution. While it will start its execution, what it will do, it may expect something which is out of this UiPath Studio may occurred in this sequence. So in that manner, it is in this. So when number is incremented to 100 and compared, it falls. So 100 should not be printed, but it's so 100. Yes, what we are doing here, we are incrementing it and we are printing it. Every time we are incrementing the number towards the 100 and we are printing. After that, it was checking the 100. Okay, so for suppose if this was happened here. Did you observe this, the difference between this and this? Okay, what have we done? We have kept assign within this, right? Okay, so before writing, it is going to do that. So before printing, I may keep this number outside here. So it will just increment and it will check. Okay, so then 100 may not be occurred like that. So you just try it in your systems, how what's the possibilities like that. Now let's see, let's use another sequence in order to print even numbers. Okay, sir, how to obtain output side by side in output console? Write line is a method which will print new line every time. We, I guess we have a method called write also. Okay. I'll get back to you about this. Is there any, if there is any activity regarding that? Okay. We'll get back to that. Let's print the even numbers, list of even numbers. Okay. Let's create a variable. Let it be number. Okay. Of type integer. Okay. And after that, I can, let's include for here. Yes, we have, there is a loop part for each. Okay, you can bring this and you can drop here. Now for each is here. Now for each is a loop. What it will accept in your UiPath Studio. Now this item, item is a default variable which will be created by the for. So that item will not be visible anywhere in your variable section, but you can use that item. You can use that item variable if you want to write in its body, in its individual body, it will use that. Okay, so that is what actually. So let's print some even numbers. So what is the logic for printing the even numbers? Can you tell me how to print the even numbers? Can you tell me what we need to do for printing the even numbers? Number modulus 2 is equal to 0. Yes, yes, we have, we can do that. Number modulus 2. Now what we'll do is we'll not go with such easy. We'll print the prime numbers. We'll print the prime numbers. Okay. Let's have a value, a number in 0. Okay. Now let's print prime numbers. I want to change the sequence. The prime number, because you all know how, what is even number, it's very easy. Let's go with the prime numbers. Of course, prime numbers is also easy, but let's do this. Okay, let's do by prime numbers. Now tell me, what will be the logic for prime number? What should be the logic for prime number? Having factors one in itself, and so how can we write? How can we write the logic? How can you just write in a programming language, like how we need to differentiate, how to generate the list of prime numbers? For suppose if I want to generate list of prime numbers from 1 to 100, so what you will be actually doing? Everyone is telling in Python, range 2 comma n, n not equal to 0, print n, n modulus 2 is equal to 0, n plus is equal to 1. Okay, let's find. So for each item in 100. What is this? It is printing something. Value of type integer cannot be converted to system.collection.enumerable. Okay, so let it be number. So can you tell me what will be the error here by using for each item in? We'll see that later. So what we need to do, we need to first of all, yes, number mod 2 is equal to 0, number plus is equal to 1, and any other? Just hold on a second. Okay, so click on okay. So in this manner we are about to open a notepad. After that, is that visible everyone? Hi, hello, I'm going to type something. After that I want to open a file. I want to save this file. I'm clicking on save as. I'm going to give like example one, okay, and click on save. And after that I want to change the font by going to one format font. I want to let it be like Bookman, like Bookman old style. Let it be. I want to make it as light italic, and I want to set a font to it as 22, and click on OK. And I want to close this. So these are the complete number of tasks that I want to do it on your notepad. Now let's start a process. Is that my screen visible? Right. I want to open a new sequence. Let it be a notepad example. I'm creating a notepad example. Right. Now, what we need to do is, I want to open a notepad. First of all, I need to open a notepad. What we need to do? For that, what we need to do, we need to click on Windows R, right? For that, we have an activity called as hotkey. Have you observed here? There is something called UI automation. In this, having a category called keyboard, that we have send hotkey. Okay. So drag this send hotkey here. Is that visible? Send hotkey is an activity where you have a controls called Alt, Control, Shift, Windows. These are the four keys that you are about to use generally. Okay. So what is you need to do? We need to click on Windows. And what is the key that you want to press? If you select the drop down, you have everything. If anything is missing, we can simply type it. So Windows plus R, I need to do it where you want to do. Okay, it is okay, it will happen, because Windows R itself is an internal system command where Windows will accept to open a run command. Okay, let's save this and let's execute whether this Windows R is working or not. Yes. Did you observe Windows R has been worked? Just an instance. Yes, it has been opened in open only. I have not typed notepad. Okay, clear that. But Windows, I'll just want to show you again. I will run and see. Did you observe? So this is what. Is it observed? Did you observe everyone the Windows R console? Please reply. Yes, like that. So that is one activity. Now, what you need to do there after opening your Windows R, what you need to do there, we need to type here, right? We need to type here. Okay, for that we have an activity called type into. We have an activity called type into. Okay, so type into where it need to do? Need to do here. Okay, if you observe this type into activity, we have something called indicate on screen where you want to type. Okay, where you want to type, if you open this Windows R, okay, you need to indicate it on screen. Where you want to indicate it on screen? Here. If you observe, everywhere you move the mouse, it will show you where you want to do it. Okay, so this is the place that you want to type, isn't it? If you select this, this place will be recorded here like this. Got it? This place will be recorded here. This should be happen immediately after your calling hotkey activity. Now what you want to type in double quotes? Notepad. Clear? Now there is, if you observe the property panel of type into, there are so many things. Okay, we'll concentrate on different things later, but there is something called as empty field. If you check this, anything if it is there in your text box where you want to type, that will be cleared. That will be cleared and that will be replaced by the text what you are typing, what have you provided here. Am I clear? Now let's see whether it is working or not. Let's save this. Okay, let's run it. Sorry, it was already in open. Let me close this. Sorry, let me close this. So nothing is there. No, but this is, let me run it again. Yes, if you observed that notepad has been replaced. So it was cleared and this notepad has been typed. There will be some applications that defaultly, it may not be in the selection. Like, first of all, if you click on Windows R like this, what was happened here? There is notepad already typed. It was in selection. So that what if it was in selection, automatically if we type anything, it will be replaced. But there will be some applications where only a text will be available without any selection. If you are embedding, if you want to type any text there, what will happen? This notepad will be typed like this. Did you got this? Why I have selected this property, why I have selected this empty field? If anything is like this, like what I have typed here before notepad, so this will be cleared. So there will be some applications which will be in unselected at start. So that will also be cleared if you select this empty field. Please remind this point. If you are doing that, it will be very helpful in when you are dealing with your desktop applications or web applications. Okay. Okay, now let's again check me whether it was working or not. Yes, notepad. Notebooks. Now what we need to do now? After your notepad, what we need to do now? Either after typing notepad, you can click on OK, or else either you can click on Enter key. So these are the two options that were available after typing something. So let's use hotkey again, because I want to open your notepad by using enter. So if there is nothing enter here in your list of keys, there will be enter. Yes, there are two things, enter and numenter. So many of your keyboards may not have numenter, but for sure you'll be having enter. Select enter. Okay, so it will automatically do this because there is nothing you are about to indicate. If you want, that means if you want to click on something, then you can do that. Okay, we will do both the things. Okay, let's save this. Okay, and run it. Have you observed your notepad has been opened? That is one procedure. Let's remove this hotkey. Let me have something called click. Click is an, there are so many activities with having a click. In the category of mouse, we have click and double click. double click is not required in order to click on OK, isn't it? If you open this, only single click is enough. If you have a single click, it will be open. So this click is enough. So just drag this click here to here. Where you need to click, that need to be recorded. Okay, indicate on screen, select on indicate on screen. Where? The thing was opened. Here, this is the button that you want to open. That this is one. If you click on cancel, it will cancel. Click on browse, it will browse. If you click on OK, it will click on OK. OK has been recorded. Let's check whether it has been working or not. OK has been clicked. Notepad has been opened. Clear? Till now, any doubts? Till now, any doubts? No doubts? Fine. So we'll go for the next thing. So after what we need to do after doing this? After this, what we need to do? We need to type something here. Okay. What is an activity for typing? That is type into. So let's drop this type into activity and bring this type into activity here. Where we need to type? So indicate on screen. So your notepad is in selection, your help, view, format, edit, file, and everything will be in selection. But where you need to type? We need to type in this area. Okay, select that. That thing will be recorded if you observed it. Okay, fine. What we need to type? Let me print. Hi, hello, welcome, something. Okay, here also you can keep empty field. Being our notepad is defaultly an empty notepad which was having nothing, so there is, because it depends on your application what you are about to use. Okay, hi, hello, welcome. Okay, let me save this and let me check. Close this notepad which was opened previously and check. Is that fine? So that is what, very simple, right? You are using an activity called click, type into. Okay, you can use send hotkey in the place of click, and you can use the enter key button in order to open your in order to open that application which you are typing in your run command. Okay, so is that fine? So after this, what we need to do, I need to save it, right? I need to save it. For saving, what we need to do? You can press Ctrl S, right? That is one option. Or else we can go to file and we need to click on save as. We'll do this. Ctrl S is very simple because using a send hotkey, using your mouse click, you'll be having some things that you need to learn. Okay, let's, so for what, for clicking, what is an activity? It's click. Okay, recently I have used, I'm bringing this click here. Where I want to click? Okay, every time while you are indicating on screen, please make that application open readily. Okay, please note that if you want to use anything like indicating on screen, please make that application readily because it was open. Make that in the background of this UiPath Studio. Don't make it as minimized. If it was minimized, if I want to indicate on screen, it won't, because if you cannot click this, if you click this, what will happen? This will be recorded. Or this something will be recorded. This is not I need to do it. Okay. So click on escape. It will come back. You click on escape. Okay. So make this open and keep it backside of your UiPath Studio. Get into your UiPath Studio. Indicate on screen. Automatically it should be on the backside. Where you need to click on your file. Your file has been recorded. Any doubts here? Please let me know. Sir, only what is TPAD? Only showing in the run command when I execute the program. That your system need to have notepad, that I cannot do. Okay. Yeah, it's sir only notepad only showing in the run command when I execute the program. So what is the problem, Rajkumar? I am not getting. Fine, let him type. Sir, can we use control S? Yes, you can use. But I want to show you something here. That's what I have used that file click. Okay? That you need to know very clearly. Is it fine by your string? Fine. Now, after what we need to do after clicking on file, you need to click on save as. Right? Let's see how we can do. What for that to click again, we need to insert the click. Okay? If you indicate on screen, make sure this was opened backside. Indicate on screen where I need to click in file. What will be recorded? Again, file only recorded. Did you got it? Again, file only recorded. Now that is not the way that we need to use click here. That's what I want to tell you. What we need to do is readily this save as need to be visible. Okay, for example, if you come out, okay, see what I am doing. I'm open making file and this thing to be open like this. I'm leaving like this. Coming to your UI path again, I can indicate on screen. If you see these three dots, I can go here and you can again indicate on screen. Okay, you can select this again. It will go. Where is that save as here? Nothing is here, right? For that, we have an option called pausing the recording. Okay, if you click on F3, sorry, so it was not working. Let me check. I guess it is F2. Sorry, F2. Are you observing here a timeout running out here? It is going to give 3 seconds for you in order to make your option to be available to your mouse pointer. So click on F2, your file will open and be ready. And click on Save As. F2 is a key where you are pausing your recording. F2. F2 is a key. The functional key F2. Okay, did you got F2? So if you click on F2, your recording will be paused for some time. Okay, now let's see whether it was happened or not. Make your notepad to close. I'm not saving it. Okay, I'm saving this entire XAML file and I'm running it. File, save as. Clear? Save as has been opened. Is it clear? Any doubts? Please let me know in the chat. I request everyone to stay in the meeting. I don't know why you are making out, where going out. If it is a feeling bore, I'm sorry because I'm teaching. I hope I'm teaching good. There any doubts till here? Fine. Now, what we need to do? We need to give a file name here. That means I need to select this text box. For that, what is the activity type into? Bring the type into here. Where I want to, I need to type here, right? So clearly indicate that on your screen. So there you are typing. Okay, what I want to type, let me give example 3. If you can type, you can type txt also. So default it may not require because in the file type it was example 3. You can type. Okay, no errors till now. So save it. Let me close this again entirely and check whether it was happening fine or not. Notepad, hi, file, save as, and you're typing there. Is that fine? It was typed. Okay, if you want to change the file format, again you need to click this. If there is anything else there, for that you need to pause the recording and you need to keep this available, and after 30 seconds you can select that. Very simple. If there are many other available, okay, that's your wish, no problem. So example 3 has been done. After this, what I can do, I need to click on save, okay, or you can click on enter. If your enter word doesn't work, your save will work for sure. Okay, so let's click on the save here. Okay, so for that, go to your UiPath, like type the activity call, click, drop down this, click here, indicate on screen, and click on save. Okay, let's do that. I'm canceling everything. Don't save. Let me save this and run. It has been saved. So if you observed this, your notepad is having a file name called example 3. Okay. Any doubts till now? Any doubts till now? No doubts? Please reply in the chat. If you have any doubts, please let me know. I hope so many are doing it parallelly. That's why they are responding very slow. It's very good that they are making it parallelly. Fine. Right. Am I audible? Nobody is responding. Fine. Now, after this, what I need to do? I want to change the font. Okay. For that, you need to click on format. To click on font, you need to select something here. Okay. Select this, select that, and everything. Okay. We'll do everything. Okay. We'll see what will happen, how much time it will take. Okay. Sir, if we run again, will it get an error? Yes, because Notepad is already open. No. Again, you want to give the example 3. Again, you may raise an error. Let's see that. Okay. Sai Vardhan, a very good question you have. Let me see that what will happen. Okay. Let's save and run it again. You got an error there, right? What is that error? Example 3.txt already exists. Okay. That means you need to change the file name in your thing. In order, that means you need to handle this also. If you want to save as, you need to handle this error also. In order to make that, you need to click on yes or no. If you are clicking on no, it will stuck there. It will not accomplish the task of save. That means your output will be incomplete. In order to make that happen, you need to handle this yes also. That's what the process is. I guess you got clear about the doubt. Fine. You did not got the error. Oh, fine. Very good. You're lucky. Now let's go to the format button. So for that, we need to click on format. Have the click here again. Indicate on screen. Click on format. So format has been recorded. After that, where I need to go? Click on, I need to go inside the format. Pause your recording by clicking F2 and click and keep get ready. So font has been recorded here. Don't forget to pause your recording by clicking on F2. It's a shortcut key to pause your record. After that, what I need to do? So in your font, after clicking this font, it need to open like this. Okay. So it will open. So we won't, because every time I need to provide the same thing, we'll execute later. So what need to done? So after clicking on font, I need to type here, right? I need to type here. So be very simple. Let's type Arial. It will be very simple. Okay, it's not coming out. Fine. So let me click again. The font here. Okay, there. Escape. It's not click activity. I need to write type into. So type into will be very easy. Instead of clicking, So type into where I need to type. I need to type in font. What you want to type? What you want to type? Let it be Arial. So after that, I need to select the font style. Okay. So again, I can use type into indicate. So I can type here. Okay. Let it be the font type be bold. Sorry, font style be bold. Okay. Next, what was there? Let the font size. I can type it as 10. Okay. Let us make it as 10. Again, type into indicate on screen. Go to size and type as 10. It won't accept because even though it is number there, but here it is string. Okay. And after that, I need to click on OK. So go to click activity. Indicate on screen. Click on OK. Okay. Let us delete example 3 here. Where is my example 3? Because I need to close this. Let me delete this. Fine. Sorry. Okay. Now let's see everything was happening fine or not. Save everything and run. Is it fine? How much time it took? 10 seconds. In 10 seconds, everything was happened. Okay. Because your typing of your text will be different. Okay. That means it may take some time to type also. So for that, it is also getting very less. Okay. So any doubts till now? Please let me know. Any doubts till now? So how to handle if you get an error while giving name that already exists? Again, you need to handle that. That means if you get that window, you need to get that. For that, there is a different process in order to handle such things. I will let you know. Sir, can you please explain from font? I'm getting an error. Okay. From font. So from font here, right? Isn't it? So here till now it is fine. So till format and you are pausing your recording and you are clicking on font. After that you are typing your font name. Okay, here for this I am here you go to use type into. Here you need to provide double quotes and after that you need to provide bold here. I'm setting my font style and I am setting the size of the font also to 10 and I'm clicking on OK. Is that clear? Who is having the doubt? How to stop an execution in middle? You need to come to your UiPath Studio and you need to stop. I'll show that again. So let me delete it again. So you're getting very unique doubts, right? Let me delete it. Let me execute this, save and run. I'm going to UiPath now. Okay. And here, there is this. I can stop. Sorry, where is this? There will be a stop button. I'm not able to see that. There is a stop button while execution also. Okay. So it was already happened backside. So click menu item file. There is an error. I cannot find the UI element corresponding selector. There's something happened. Control name file role pop up menu. Yeah, what was happened is while it was clicking on pop-up menu, I am doing an operation here. I am clicking here and there. So there, the click option may got override by the mouse, this mouse. So you need to be very sure. But while executing, there will be something called stop here. There is yes, but I cannot observe. We can stop here. I'll let you know later what will happen. Okay. So after this. So let me close this again. Let us execute and let complete. Let can be complete till there. Notepad. Okay. Save as example 3 format font Arial bold 10. Same will be remained because previously it was happened. So after that, I need to close it. So we have something called close window and activity. Close application or close window, anything. So you can use close application. So I need to after this, I need to do this close application. What application that you want to close? Indicate. This is the application that you want to close. Not this. Not this. This is the application. Click on this. So entire application will be closed. Okay. Save it. And let me delete this again because you are in a testing stage. Again, go to your path. Okay. Save it and run it. Yes, it has been closed. Nothing is visible here. It has been closed. Very simple, right? This is about this notepad example. Are you having any doubts here? We have what we have learned here today here. We have learned something called click, hotkey, and type into activities. Okay, these are the three activities we have learned: click, type into, and send hotkey activities. So using these activities, we can control some desktop applications. We can operate on desktop applications, and we can do that. So does these events occur one by one with mouse clicks? We are doing that only. Devadeep, we are using mouse click only most of the time, each and every time. Is that the doubt, or is there anything else? Let me know, Devadeep. Yeah, fine. We are using this mouse click only. We are doing that everything. Yeah, about this editor thing. Yes, we can do that. What is the problem? You know, there I will show you. If you are using your notepad. If you're going your format and font, you need to drag this. For suppose if you are want to select this perpetua, until where you need to drag? Do you know that? You cannot. You cannot assume that at some place this is perpetua is there. So that is impossible. That is very crucial thing where your UiPath to robot cannot identify what was happening. In order to reduce, and we are having an option also to type here. So it depends on the application, the activity that you are about to use on. So if it is being, there is a chance to type something here, use that. If there is no chance, that will be very challenging thing because you need to drag, you need to mouse here, you need to click on, you need to click here. How many times you will click? How many times? At one click, it will go once. At one click, it will go once. So it is very difficult in order to eradicate. You can do this. And many of the applications, even in web applications, there is a search bar. You can type there. Right? So you can type here, you can type here, you can type here. That's an option. You can just type, use the type into action activity. Is that clear, Devadeep? Sir, can we make it run without opening UiPath Studio at like at time of startup? Yes, we can do it. We can do that. That is at later stage. At later, we can do that using your UiPath. UiPath robot, sir, font changes cannot being applied for me. It will be applied because previously we have set to Arial, Bold and 10. So defaultly those fonts will be remain same. So every time if you want to execute, please change the font style, size and everything. It will change. It will change. Please check that, Bhavyasri. Ashwin, I sorry to stop. Telling you about that, we can use that without using UiPath Studio. We can use that. I will tell you at in the last classes, because that is what the project deployment is. You are about to deploy your entire XAML file into a robot directly, and your robot will take care what to do. I changed, sir, but I was not getting. Please check carefully. It will happen. Check very carefully. Okay. Sir, if I want to save more than one notepad file, it shows the file already exists. How to do that in a single sequence? Yes, that means you need to handle it. That you need to handle that also. That need to be raised under an if condition. If you get an error or if you get this window, that will be seen later, because you need to identify it later stages, because you need to identify it whether that window has been existing or not. The same doubt, right? For suppose if I want to go to save, right? Click on example one. If you save it, this is an error which will be raised by your system. You need to handle this. That means you need to write such a sequence that your bot need to identify this also. Okay, so what thing that you can save? That means you need to identify whether it has been existing or not. That we will show you in later on examples. We will tell you whether this has been existed or not something. There are so many such activities which will identify what need to be identified and what I need to react upon such errors. We will learn it later. So then we can apply it here without any problems. Please remind me later when I'm teaching any such type of activity. Please remind me. We will apply on the notepad. So how can I store the file in a particular location? You can do it. So go to file, go to save as. Okay, here you can type the address. If you have URL, type into here, and you can type the direct address. That means how can we get that URL? Or suppose if you go to your this PC, suppose it's only having C. If you go into C here, if you right click here, you can get copy address as text. Okay. So if you go to UiPath, for suppose, let me have one activity type into, for example, selection here in double quotes, sorry, double quotes, I can give the path of the folder where you want to save. Then he this need to be typed where I need to type here. So this need to be recorded, and there you can type it. That's also happened. Before clicking on save, you need to do that. Is that doubt clear? Who is that asked? Karanam. Yes, you can do it. It will happen. That is what we need to do. We need to provide this. It will happen. So check carefully. You need to provide in double quotes and everything. It will happen. So before save, it need to be done. Okay. Any other doubts? So no more doubts, right? Let's wind up here about today's session. Thank you for your participation. Sir, I'm still getting an error. It will happen. Okay. How to stop execution? I will let you know how to stop. There is stop button actually while it was executing. I am unable to see here. It will stop. You can press escape, I guess. While it was running, you can press escape, I guess. Okay, let me see. I'm deleting this. We save this. Yes, I have escaped. What I have escaped? I have escaped the run command. Now your UiPath will wait for 30 seconds. Your UiPath will wait for 30 seconds and it will show the error. Okay, so this is one of the things that you can just click on, not happening anything. That means while you're using your mouse activity, no, you can use that mouse activity some other place at that time. which will change the sequence activity in which this robot has linked with your system. Then automatically how it will find an error. So it will find an error that the mouse has been moved from one activity to another activity, which has been intervened by the user. So in that manner, it will identify and it will, the execution was halted or it was actually interrupted. Okay. In between also stop is there. I am unable to find it. I will let you know tomorrow. Okay. Yes. Today also tomorrow, yesterday's class was not yet written. I couldn't click on that path. It's not about click on. It's about, you can go here and you can right click. You can copy it first. Copy that and you can type into. Type into will work, ma'am. I will show you. I'll show you. Once again, I have copied it, right? Let me go to type into. Okay, indicate on screen. Sorry, it was not there, right? Let me open. Notepad. Save as. So here I need to do it, right? Okay, indicate on screen. Yes, it was happening. So you need to keep mouse here. Did you observe? So it was recording. So can we use a variable to rectify the already exists error by assigning value initially and at the time of saving, we can add the variable plus plus while it works. That may not. That may not. There is another activities. In order to identify that, I will tell you when we go more deeper in the applications. Okay, no worries, Nagendra. Please remind me when I am telling that. There are some activities in order to identify whether it has been existing or not. Okay, so then at that time we will do that. Okay, no worries. Okay, I hope I have cleared so many of your doubts. Recordings today's and yesterday's will be done. Yesterday you showed us the lab manual where we can be found. You cannot find it. We as an instructor, we got that lab manual. So after that, we will share it to you. After the every program, what we are doing, we will do it. So could you please tell us which course we have to register in UiPath? You need to do RPA foundation. And let me show you academy.uipath.com. So just log in with your registered mail ID using which mail ID you have registered under your UiPath. Okay. So it is going to document, sir. You need to type into there. You need to provide the URL, Umesh Chandra. You need to type there. Okay. Here in your dashboard, in your learning plans, you'll find, that means you need to start reading it. Just you need to find it, the course called RPA Developer Foundation. You search it in the courses, you will find it. And like RPA Developer, you can search it, you will get Russian Introduction to RPA Developer. This is also fine. Okay, go to that course. So this is about the introduction only, the RPA developer. No data found. Okay. Here in your learning plans, you will get RPA developer foundation. No worries. Russian, this is an English one. RPA developer foundation. Is it clear? In your learning plans, it is there. Okay. Yes, fine. Yes, you will find. I'll give you the tasks. Okay. From tomorrow onwards, we will discuss about the task that you want to complete so that you will be also practicing in your systems. Any other doubts? Any other doubts? Thank you very much for attending the session. Okay. We will save these recordings in the Beam Placement YouTube channel. Okay. Thank you. I'm stopping this class for now. Thank you very much.